In physics, the Lorentz transformation are coordinate transformations between two coordinate frames that move at constant velocity relative to each other. Frames of reference can be divided into two groups, inertial and non-inertial. The term Lorentz transformations only refers to transformations between inertial frames, usually in the context of special relativity. In each reference frame, an observer can use a local coordinate system to measure lengths, and a clock to measure time intervals. An observer is a real or imaginary entity that can take measurements, say humans, or any other living organism, or even robots and computers. An event is something that happens at a point in space at an instant of time, or more formally a point in spacetime. The transformations connect the space and time coordinates of an event as measured by an observer in each frame. They supersede the Galilean transformation of Newtonian physics, which assumes an absolute space and time. The Galilean transformation is a good approximation only at relative speeds much smaller than the speed of light. Lorentz transformations have a number of unintuitive features that do not appear in Galilean transformations. For example, they reflect the fact that observers moving at different velocities may measure different distances, elapsed times, and even different orderings of events, but always such that the speed of light is the same in all inertial reference frames. The invariance of light speed is one of the postulates of special relativity. Historically, the transformations were the result of attempts by Lorentz and others to explain how the speed of light was observed to be independent of the reference frame, and to understand the symmetries of the laws of electromagnetism. The Lorentz transformation is in accordance with special relativity, but was derived before special relativity. The transformations are named after the Dutch physicist Hendrik Lorentz. The Lorentz transformation is a linear transformation. It may include a rotation of space. A rotation-free Lorentz transformation is called a Lorentz boost. In Minkowski space, the mathematical model of space-time in special relativity, the Lorentz transformations preserve the space-time interval between any two events. This property is the defining property of a Lorentz transformation. They describe only the transformations in which the space-time event at the origin is left fixed. They can be considered as a hyperbolic rotation of Minkowski space. The more general set of transformations that also includes translations is known as the Poincaré group. History. Many physicists, including Waldemar Voigt, George Fitzgerald, Joseph Larmor, and Hendrik Lorentz himself, had been discussing the physics implied by these equations since 1887. Early in 1889, Oliver Heaviside had shown from Maxwell's equations that the electric field surrounding a spherical distribution of charge should cease to have spherical symmetry once the charge is in motion relative to the ether. Fitzgerald then conjectured that Heaviside's distortion result might be applied to a theory of intermolecular forces. Some months later, Fitzgerald published the conjecture that bodies in motion are being contracted. In order to explain the baffling outcome of the 1887 ether wind experiment of Michelson and Morley, in 1892, Lorentz independently presented the same idea in a more detailed manner, which was subsequently called Fitzgerald-Lorentz contraction hypothesis. Their explanation was widely known before 1905. Lorentz and Larmor, who believed the luminiferous ether hypothesis, also looked for the transformation under which Maxwell's equations are invariant when transformed from the ether to a moving frame. They extended the Fitzgerald-Lorentz contraction hypothesis and found out that the time coordinate has to be modified as well. Henri Poincaré gave a physical interpretation to local time as the consequence of clock synchronization, under the assumption that the speed of light is constant in moving frames. Larmor is credited to have been the first to understand the crucial time dilation property inherent in his equations. In 1905, Poincaré was the first to recognize that the transformation has the properties of a mathematical group, and named it after Lorentz. Later in the same year, Albert Einstein published what is now called special relativity. By deriving the Lorentz transformation under the assumptions of the principle of relativity and the constancy of the speed of light in any inertial reference frame, and by abandoning the mechanical ether derivation, an event is something that happens at a certain point in spacetime, or more generally, the point in spacetime itself. In any inertial frame, an event is specified by a time coordinate t and a set of Cartesian coordinates x, y, z to specify position in space in that frame. Subscripts label individual events. From Einstein's second postulate of relativity follows immediately in all inertial frames for events connected by light signals. The quantity on the left is called the space-time interval between events and the interval between any two events, not necessarily separated by light signals, is in fact invariant, i.e., independent of the state of relative motion of observers in different inertial frames, as is shown here. The transformation sought after thus must possess the property that where t, x, y, z are the spacetime coordinates used to define events in one frame, and t, x, y, z are the coordinates in another frame. Now one observes that a linear solution to the simpler problem solves the general problem too. Finding the solution to the simpler problem is just a matter of look up in the theory of classical groups that preserve bilinear forms of various signature. The Lorentz transformation is thus an element of the group O, or, for those that prefer the other metric signature, generalities. The relations between the primed and unprimed space-time coordinates are the Lorentz transformations. Depending on how the frames move relative to each other, and how they are oriented in space relative to each other, other parameters that describe direction, speed, and orientation enter the transformation equations. Transformations describing relative motion with constant velocity and without rotation of the space coordinate axes are called aboosts, and the relative velocity between the frames is the parameter of the transformation. The other basic type of Lorentz transformations is rotations in the spatial coordinates only. These are also inertial frames since there is no relative motion, the frames are simply tilted, and in this case quantities defining the rotation are the parameters of the transformation. A combination of a rotation and boost is a homogeneous transformation, which transforms the origin back to the origin. The full Lorentz group O also contains special transformations that are neither rotations nor boosts, but rather reflections in a plane through the origin. Two of these can be singled out: spatial inversion, in which the spatial coordinates of all events are reversed in sign, and temporal inversion, in which the time coordinate for each event gets its sign reversed. Boosts should not be conflated with mere displacements in space-time. In this case, the coordinate systems are simply shifted and there is no relative motion. However, these also count as symmetries forced by special relativity since they leave the space-time interval invariant. A combination of a rotation with a boost, followed by a shift in space-time, is an inhomogeneous Lorentz transformation. An element of the Poincaré group, which is also called the inhomogeneous Lorentz group,